Sorry about that, Windom Eagles fans. We're having a little technical difficulties with the broadcasting here. 6:17 left in the first quarter of the Windom Eagles versus MCW Mavericks. MCW making a march down the field with some very good plays. As
QB there over the middle.
Passes number three up the middle. Very nice play. It's going to take him just about the 13-yard line. There by the Maverick. Back up.
Turn on a keeper tackle made by Zach Steen.
Dangerous one down here. Second down, 18 to go here on the 21-yard line. Quarterback drops back. Runs out of options. Goes to his right. And is taken out of bounds.
Run out of bounds by number 77. Go on, Zach Senior. Big loss. That'll bring up third down and maybe about 25. Maybe third down about 21.
That'll bring up third down at about 21 here. Puts them back on the 25-yard line. Quarterback drops back.
Quarterback sack.
And part of the big play there for the Eagles.
Awesome, about 10 yards, brings up fourth down and 31.
Mavericks with a loss of about 10 yards, that'll bring up a fourth and 31. Puts the ball on the 35-yard line. 4:30 to go here in the first quarter. Very big play there by senior Adam Farag. Yep.
The Mavericks are now in punt formation.
Deep punt.
Excellent with a high booming punt into the end zone, rolls through the end zone. Will he win the football at the 28?
Richard Ekman was the punter on that play as he kicked it in the end zone. We'll put the Eagles on the 20-yard line. Eagles looking to get something good here. Start the game off right in the first quarter. 4 minutes left. They're going to have two receiver to Huska's left and right as he is in shotgun formation. Out behind Huska. He's Zamzow goes in motion, handoff to Hog up the middle. Decent run there, gained about 5 yards, not bad to get started.
Yep. Hog on the run Jonas, up the middle.
Jonas Hog being one of Windom's foreign exchange student. He is from Norway, I believe.
And yep. Number 70 is Logan Ebeling.
Very athletic. He's had a couple good games this season so far. He also plays football over there in Norway on an AAU team, I think. Yep. Husk is going to be in shotgun formation again, receiver to his left and right. Hand off to Hog up the middle, and a nice run there again as he gets another 6 or 7 yard run there to get the first down. Very nice running there by Jonas Hog.
Aaron Burmeister. And Hog is going to carry there for a Windom Eagle first down.
Couple Eagles on the 34-yard line. 3:20 here to go in the first quarter. Looks like it's going to be the same formation. Receiver to the left and right, shotgun. Hand off to Hog again, up the middle.
Once
and
again,
another decent five-yard run there. Yep,
and
just pounded it to the right side there.
The 40-yard line. On a tackle for the Bams. The Ebelings, Jacob is 68 and Logan is number 70. Again, six brings up second and four.
That'll bring up second and four here on the 40-yard line. And it looks like he'll be in the same formation. Yep. Well, looks like one of the MCW players there.
Yeah, flag down.
Number 56 on there on the line. Aaron Anderson jumped there a little bit. I don't know if he crossed the line or anything, but I assume that's what it's going to be.
Yep. Refs are discussing that right now.
Encroachment against the Mavericks will be a 5-yard gain for the Eagles, and that will be a first down.
I'm going to give the Eagles a first down on that penalty, y'all.
You'll be able to read all about this team next week in the Cottonwood County Citizen. Joel Alstead is here.
Well, on the 45-yard line here. Husker in shotgun formation. Gilbertson in fast to the left and right. Hand off to Holland. And he gets hit pretty hard there.
Maybe a gain of a yard or two.
How about they carry Anderson to tackle along with Italy? Short gain that time, just 2 yards, brings up second down and eight.
Looks like the Eagles have been running the same formation this last five or six plays.
Yep, giving the ball to Haug, I believe, every play, going to the right. Looks like they're setting up in the same formation again.
Nielsen goes in motion, and it's pitched back to Devin. He's looking for some room blocking.
Gain of about 3 yards there, maybe two.
Devin Nielsen carries it to midfield. On to tackle number two, Brandon Williamson, along with 33, Dylan Jones.
MCW having a pretty big team, as they have quite the size over there on the sideline.
Yep.
We have two receivers to the left and right. Husker and shotgun. A little screen out to Gilbertson as he can't come up with it. Gilbertson's going and finding some room as he goes all the way to the side, Windom Eagle sideline. Looks like he was about 10, 15 yards behind the line of scrimmage.
Making something out of nothing. All-around athlete, sophomore Luke Gilbertson makes a big-time play there.
It's going to bring him right back to where they were.
That pass was just a hair too high for Gilbertson.
What could have been a maybe 20-yard loss ends up being right back to the line of scrimmage.
Fourth down and five. The ball's on the 50-yard line. Fourth down and five here. 37 seconds to go here in the first quarter. Receiver to the left and right. Possibly seeing a punt here. Yep, Nielsen drops back. Looks like he will be punting. Not a bad punt that'll push him back there. Lands about on the 20-yard line as Williamson brings it back. He's looking to the left side of the field but runs out of bounds about the 25-yard line. Nice punt there by
Nielsen. Williamson on the return. He's run out of bounds there by Devin Homer. Nice punt by Devin Nielsen. Martin County West football. First and 10 for the Mavericks. Looks like it's going to be spotted at about the 24-yard line. Or is that the 29? It's the 29.
MCW coming off a loss of last week against St. James. Possibly turning that into a W this week, but Windom Eagles looking very tough out there. Shotgun, gives it to the running back up the middle, but doesn't look like he gained anything.
Nope. Looks like they gained zero there. Clock will run down to about 10 seconds right now.
Jones on the carry, tackle made by Zach Steen along with Quinkman.
Both teams take our back out on the field. MCW is going to start their drive on the 25-yard line. They're on the 28-yard line. Ethan Hearn does an option play. Pitches it out to number 33.
Pretty nice.
Good gain there, about 10 or 11 yards.
Dylan Jones on the carry. Tackles made by
Dylan Jones on the carry there.
It has to be a first down for the Mavericks. Nice run for Dylan Jones.
Two receivers to Hearn's left and right.
Hearn on
run up the middle. Hearn kept it.
On a tackle, Homer.
Maybe about a gain of five, though. Hearn. Not a bad run by the quarterback there.
Four-yard gain brings up second and six.
So far, both offenses have been running the ball for the most part. A couple passing plays here or there, but for the most part, running the ball.
Right. Not much of a gain on their passing, so we'll see how much of the running game keeps up.
Yep.
Two receivers to the left and right. Hand off to Jones up the middle, who gets
Jones, open field,
a lot of room up in the middle, but gets tackled by Sam Huska there.
But Jones rips through gain that about for about a 13-yard gain and 15, another Mark Dunny West yards. First down.
I'll put the ball on the 42-yard line, first and 10.
Looks like the same formation as last play. Two receivers to the left and right as Jones is to Hearn's left. Handoff up the middle again, but gets met by Zach Steen. Very nice play there by senior Zach Steen, who tackles him for a loss.
Dylan Jones on the carry. Loss of a couple of yards. Forward progress marked on the line of scrimmage at second and 10.
That'll bring up a second and 10 for the Mavericks.
Timeout call there.
Timeout call by the Mavericks.
The Mavericks.
9:55 left in the second quarter. Game going by pretty fast tonight on this chilly night. It's about 55 degrees, I'd say.
Yep.
As my buddy here, Austin Haken, is wearing his snowmobile jacket. Made by Arctic, yeah.
Serving wings, hamburgers, and appetizers every Friday night until the end of the football season.
Both teams taking the field now.
Second and 10 for the Mavericks. And Hearn will be in shotgun formation. Jones to his left. Drops back to pass. He looks to his left to Richard Ackman, who he looks.
Picked off by Lightning. Very nice defensive play there by Lightning as he jumps in front of the line of steam. Richard Ackman is big. At the 11-yard line. Wow, what a play.
Nice play there by Minion.
Minion's interception.
Minion is a sophomore this year.
Yep.
He's having a very athletic play. Very athletic play there.
Yep.
And he puts the football to Windom.
Looked like it was kind of a short pass there by Ethan Hearn.
Yep, came up a little short. And Minion located the ball and dove in front of the receiver.
Pitch back to Nielsen as he goes out to the left side, looking for some blocking, but doesn't find any. Looks like a gain of zero.
Maybe a loss of one.
Tackle made by Dylan Jones, number 33 for the man.
It's more in the computer. So,
okay. Maybe a gain of zero there. Bringing up a second and 10 at the ball on the 12-yard line. 9:20 to go in the first quarter.
Sam Husker going to be under center. Nielsen goes in motion, fake pitch back, and it's a handoff to Ryan Zamzow to the right side. And
ball is carried by Ryan Zamzow.
Gain of a couple yards, but nothing big, maybe two or three. I don't know, it's going to bring up third and seven, but Eagles got to do something here to get somewhere.
Yep.
Not doing really much to get too many yards, you know?
Yep.
Number 37 on the tackle, Matt Waller.
Husker going to be in shotgun formation with Austin Fast to his left, Luke Gilbert to his right.
Need a big play here by the Eagles to keep the offense going.
A little screen pass there to Devin Nielsen, but it's kind of tripped up there. Gained about one, but not going to be enough.
Nope, not enough.
It'll be a short game. From their own 16-yard line, the Eagles are now faced with a 4th and 6.
Be 4th and 6 now here. Eagles on the 16-yard line. I believe they will punt here. Have Nielsen dropping back. And Nielsen punts it. Short punt. Rolling out of bounds at about the 52-yard line.
At the Eagle 47-yard line, so the Mavs will start with a really good field position here.
Mavericks going to start their drive here on the 46-yard line. Very good field positioning for them. And they can probably take advantage of this and score a touchdown. 7:35 left in the second quarter. Still scoreless.
Two to his right, two to his left. Rolls to his left and gets tackled.
Looks like that was an option play that he kept it.
Yep. Gained about 3 yards maybe.
Third down and quarterback keeper.
yellow flag thrown on the play, though, back in the line of scrimmage.
On the tackle,
possible holding call, but we'll see.
Holding penalty is going against the Mavericks.
Bring him back 5 yards.
That marches Martin County West back to the 43-yard line. Their own kick on Thursday.
Yeah, it was 10 yards. Was it 10 yards, Houston?
Yes, that's right. It's 10 yards. The Mavericks will face a first down and 21 with the ball on the 43-yard line. To the left, and nearly picked off by Wyatt Minion again.
The pass is nice broken up by Wyatt Minion. An injury on the field.
Looks like Austin Bass is going to be down on the play. Grabbing his, looks like his right knee.
Yep. Didn't quite see what happened there for the play there to Austin.
Looks like he's in a lot of pain as he's squirming back and forth.
Yep. Appears to be his right knee.
The injured player is Austin Fast.
Jeff Huska.
We're going to cut to a little commercial break here. Back up, walking him up, but it's not too much as he is in
Wildcats will welcome
this winter.
Wildcats. One time powers
would hate to lose a player
ball.
There. Yep.
The Orioles were the Trimont Orioles, and the Raiders were the Sherburn Raiders, the last team to win the one-class Minnesota State basketball tournament in 1970
teams
when they destroyed the South St. Paul Packers. And the state championship game at Williams Arena.
Second and 21 here, ball on the 43-yard line. Trips to the left.
Turning back, dropping back, throws to his right. Where it is caught.
Wow. That is pass and catch. Pretty well defended by Devin Nielsen,
there.
But Burns' pass is caught.
Looked like it was caught by number three, Jacob Buttinger. But Devin
Burns
Nielsen,
Buncher
the defender, came
Kansas,
up with it, so not sure how that all turned out. But
anyway, it's enough for
it looks to be at there in
County West first
down. MCW ball.
Yep. Big play there by the Mavericks.
Right on spot, too. That pass was very nice.
Yep, perfect pass. Right over the top.
Trips to the left again. Hand off to Dylan Jones to the right.
Dylan Jones
nice
on
run
the
there. In about 7 or 8 yards.
Luke Gilbertson along with Devin Homer on the tackle for the Eagles.
Winding down to about 6 minutes here in the second quarter. second and four, the ball on the 18-yard line, pitch to his left, one to his right.
Quarterback keep there, he's running to his left, finds some room. But taken down by number 53, Devin Homer.
On the keeper, Ethan Hearn on the tackle, Devin Homer.
Change their move, it's a first down.
Nina six, turns up. Brett makes another first down for the Mavericks.
Oh, is there no more prepping?
Mavericks with the first down here, ball on the 13-yard line.
Trips to the right now.
Timeout called by
Martin County West. That'll be their second time out of the half. 5:31 left.
Popcorn smells good. The concession stand is open and will be open at halftime.
So far tonight, a lot of running the ball here from both teams. A couple passing plays here and there, but not very many completions here until the Mavericks came up with that nice play, passing play.
And just a little friendly reminder out to you watching is that you can follow us on Twitter. Crew22 Media is the Twitter handle where we will tweet live updates of the games. So give us a follow.
Both teams taking the field now. 5:31 to go here in the second quarter. First and 10, ball on the 13-yard line. Trips to the right again.
Quarterback keep as Ethan Hearn runs up the middle, but gets pretty hard there by Jesse Hearn Pickman. Pickman, number 75.
Gave about two or three big tackle made by Jesse Pickman.
Pickman being a junior this year.
Every time you see the zoom in, they throw it.
That is about a 4-yard gain. Close to five. We second down and six.
That'll bring up a second down and six here for the Mavericks. Ball on the 9-yard line.
Quarterback keep there again. As Ethan Hearn spins through there and gets into the end zone.
Twisting and spinning his way into the end zone is Martin County West junior quarterback Ethan Hearn.
9-yard run there to get that touchdown.
Yep.
Very athletic play.
And that gives the Mavericks 6 points.
A couple nice moves there by their quarterback.
Well executed drive highlighted by that big pass play from Hearn to Buncher. Williamson will now try to PA kick with Buncher holding.
Extra point coming. Brandon Williamson, lefty, kicking it. Kick is up, but it is not good.
Kick is short. May have been blocked a little bit.
May have been tipped by one of the Eagles.
With 4:42 to go in the second quarter, MCW now owning a 6-0 lead.
Eagles are surely going to have to step it up. No more short offensive drives. We need long ones, touchdowns.
Yep. They need to mix it up a little here with some runs.
Whatever they're doing isn't working very well.
Yep, we need to change something here.
Tomorrow afternoon, the Minnesota Gophers will take on the Colorado State College.
As we have a short break here, we're going to give a little shout out to our Crew 22 right now. We got Yanick Tade on the camera, Ethan on the video mixer, along with Alex Woizeschke. We got John Irwin down at the camera 3, and Brian OG Bang Bang down on camera 2. We got myself, awesome, very nice crew we got going on tonight as they all showed up and actually doing something for us.
Yep.
We got myself, awesome Haken, and Matt Theesfeld commentating your game. Kick it is up, Brandon Williamson, number 2, kicks it. Nielsen receives it as he's looking for some blocking room, but it's not getting much.
Devin Nielsen on the return. He should be joined there by several tacklers, number 11. Cyrus, number 11, 27
still on the sidelines, not starting this drive. like we're going to have Wyatt Minion start.
Louis
start this one for him.
From the 30-yard line.
Awesome pass, still on the sideline after he injured his right knee.
Husky and shotgun formation, receivers to left and right. Hand off to Haug up the middle. Good push there, maybe gain about 3 yards.
Yep. Eagles sticking to the right side of the offense when they run the ball so far tonight. Giving the ball to Howell.
The tacklers to the Mavericks.
Only 4 minutes left of the half. Eagles really need to push their way towards their side of the field. Huskin shotgun formation, flip back to Howard at the middle, who spins his way a little bit there.
Looks like they
came up about a yard short of the first down there.
Not a bad run, but
no.
On attack from Jacob Elfling along with Carter Willie. That's enough for a first down there for the Eagles.
Yeah, looks like they came up short, but got a first down.
That's going to be a shotgun formation again. Looks like this is working for him.
Yep, fast back in the game.
Nielsen goes in motion, hand off Haug to his left.
Haug in the carry.
Gets met up there by the line of scrimmage. Gain of maybe a yard or two.
Yep. And Carter Willie.
Not much of a gain there by the Eagles.
Gain of 2 brings up 2nd down and 8.
They'll bring up 2nd down and 8. 3:10 left here in the second quarter.
Zamzow goes in motion, handoff out up the middle again, but it's met up with a big mob of Mavericks there.
Yep.
Not a big game.
Number 37, Matt Moore. Senior linebacker from Montgomery West on the tackle. Third down and 5.
Eagles need to get something going here because they're down 6-0 with roughly 2 minutes left in the second quarter. The ball in the 45. Husker rolls right. Forces right. And Austin Fast.
Austin Fast makes a catch. Open field tackle there made by Ethan Hearn.
Very nice pass there.
Yep. Good location.
Over Dryers is marking up for a Windom Eagle first down past midfield.
I'll give the Eagles a first down. The ball on the 49-yard line.
Haskell shotgun again. Sands out goes in motion.
Flag is thrown.
Flag is thrown there on the play though.
Mavericks, yep, that's the second tonight, I believe.
That's going to make it first down and 5.
Make it first and 5. Moving the Eagles a little bit. Clock down to 1:56, though, so they're going to have to get moving here if they want to score before halftime.
Yep. Crunch time right now here. It'd be nice if the Eagles can score here before halftime. Sam's on motion.
And off the out.
Good stop in the end.
Howe is going to be pulled for a loss by Ebeling and Bowler.
It's not good.
And Windom will call a timeout here with a minute 41
Windom calls a timeout here.
In the second quarter.
Trying to get something together before the half is over. 1:41 left. Cut to a little commercial break here. That's Scoreboard whistle. Both teams taking the field. Eagles are going to have to put something here together. We want to get some points.
Yep, need to get a score here before halftime.
Came in with 0 points. I don't know what I'm saying, Austin.
I know what you're saying, Matt Theesfeld.
How's it going, shotgun? He's dropping back. And the whistle's blown.
The flag down negates the play.
False start there on the
offense. Penalty is going to go against the Eagles. False start penalty. Going to move it right back.
Who that was, but he's going to bring him back 5 yards.
Yep. That'll put them on the 50-yard line. Putting the Eagles at a 2nd-and-11 here. 1:38 to go.
We have two receivers left and right of Huskies using shotgun formation out behind them. Zamzow goes in motion. Huskies looking to pass. Not much time, and he's going to end throwing it to Austin fast.
Austin pass is caught on the
just
side.
Just as he runs out of bounds, getting about 5 yards there.
Yep.
Ball will be right at the 45-yard line.
Austin Fast moving with Sam Huska moving to the sideline.
You know, Austin Fast is a very key receiver there for Sam.
Third down at about 6.
Has looked towards him almost every passing play. In previous games, he has gotten quite the amount of passes.
Yep. Austin Fast there being very quick. Being a very quick receiver. Gilbertson being another good receiver. That's good also is right.
Austin pass is same play. Pass. Incomplete.
Incomplete pass.
Nice job on the coverage by Ethan Hearn. Brings up 4th and 5. 4th and 6.
So bring up a 4th and 6. Ball on 45. Seven here to go in the 2nd quarter.
Husker in shotgun. Nielsen goes in motion. Throws it back to punt. Not what we wanted from the Eagles this drive. Williamson receiving. He's going to get tagged down by the 10-yard line.
Nice punt there by Nielsen.
It's too bad we couldn't
Williamson
get anything going on that.
Yep.
Tackled by Austin Fast, along with Luke Gilbertson.
That last drive there by the Eagles power got pretty much shut down on the Mavericks defense.
The Mavericks are deep in their own territory. Nice punt there by Devin Nielsen.
.116
left. They'll set it their own 10-yard line,
half.
The Mavericks will.
Early the Mavericks will receive at halftime as they did kick off the Eagles. Begin the game.
Mavericks line up with 2 to the left, 2 to the right. Hand off up the middle. With the gain of about 3 yards.
Tackle there by Zach Steen.
Dylan Jones on the carry.
Zach Steen being a
senior
this year.
Tackle for Windom. The Eagles take a timeout here. 25 seconds to play in the first half.
Mavericks face with a third and
there
seven.
There will not be any performance by the Pep Band at halftime, so you've got time to get over to the concession stand. And they got all kinds of good things for you. Concession stand at halftime.
Very chilly night tonight.
With
about
53
degrees. Not much wind. Overall, not too bad. Too bad of a night for a football game. Don't you say, Matt?
I agree. Definitely agree. Both teams taking the field now.
25 seconds left here before the end of the first half.
That will be the end of your first half. MCW leads the Windom Eagles 6-0.
At the end of the first half,
Team doing very well on offense, 6-0. Very good running plays, but Eagles could not get it together to score.
There's a signal for the halftime.
Yeah, both teams running the ball a lot with a few passing plays here and there. One big play by the Mavericks that led to their touchdown.
Ethan Hearn was the person who got that touchdown, the quarterback there, who had about a 10-yard sneak.
Yep.
And we're going to take a short break here as the halftime. We're going to bring you to some commercials, so stay tuned and we'll be back with your second half. Clock takes down. Going to bring up the second half here.
And the Eagles will kick
Mavericks
off.
Leading the Eagles 6-0. Hopefully the Eagles can get something together here and come back and win this game.
That's right.
Me personally, I don't know about you, Matt, but I expect the Eagles to change something around here the second half. Maybe throw some more passing plays.
The Mavericks have been
somewhat successful with
the
short passing game.
The boys squad in particular was very impressive.
Running game at the beginning of the game wasn't too bad, but then eventually
Windom finished fourth.
They shut the top down.
Getting really good lead runs from John Irwin, Nicholas Green, and Isaac Tade. And Ethan Clerc. Ethan Blair. I'll get it.
Eagles taking the field now. Mavericks as well.
Eagle Invitational will take the Windom ball.
Eagles are
going to
kick off
Monday, September 21.
We got Jacob Buttinger and Brandon Williamson back to receive the kick. Devin Homer's kicking for the Windom Eagles.
Devin Homer with the good boot.
Devin Homer will boot it off here. Buttinger and Williamson deep for the man.
Short kick, rolls out of bounds.
Not rough, right?
On the 8-yard line. Yep.
Spotted at the 35-yard line.
Well, 35-yard line after the out of bounds there. Ethan Hearn in shotgun formation, receivers to his left and right. Going to be the option play as he keeps it, breaks a few tackles. Go right up the middle, but hit hard.
Ethan Hearn finally brought down there by number...
He gained about maybe 1 yard.
Alessio was in on that play along with Austin Fax. Finished off, I believe, by Adam Ferry. And a yard, second down and nine.
The second and nine for the Mavericks. Two receivers to the left and right again.
Ball on the 36-yard line. Screen to the left. Nice contact by Devin Holman.
Devin Homer with a nice open field tackle. Can you hear that one up here?
Devin Homer there with a big hit there on Richard Heckman. Helmet came off on Homer. Looked like some controversy between the two players, but nothing was called by refs.
Looked like number 88 there got in the face of Devin Homer.
And a three brings up third down and six.
Whistle is blown, the flag is thrown. Not sure what happened, but we'll see what the refs say.
Five-yard penalty brings up third and 11.
Yeah, five-yard penalty against the Mavericks, so we give them third and 11. It's the ball on the 34-yard line. Trips to the right, one to the left. And another flag.
Looks like it's going to be a delay of game on
the
Mavericks.
Another delay of game penalty called against the Mavericks.
It's not good. Back-to-back penalties.
Down yep, 16.
That puts them back. 5 yards, it looks like. Puts the ball on the 29-yard line. Brings up a third and 16.
Long pass to the right. Nearly intercepted by, looks like, Will Gilbertson as it was tipped up in the air. Very close to being a catch, though, there by Williamson.
Pass, yep. Critical Williamson.
Tall player, he could have gone up
broke
and got
up
it,
by
but
Luke Gilbert.
Right off the hands. Couldn't come up with it. Yep. Very good play, though. It's going to bring up fourth and 16.
Nice defensive stand by the Eagles.
Going to force the Mavericks to more than likely punt. Boot there by Heckman. Nielsen Fair catches it just at the 32-yard line.
For by Devin Nielsen. Really winning the football from the Eagle 32-yard line.
At the ball at the 32-yard line for the Eagles. 10:15 left here in the third quarter. The Mavericks lead the Eagles 6-0.
Husk is going to be in shotgun formation, receivers to his left and right. Hand off to Haug up the middle, he goes to the right a little bit.
Still on scene and taken down by a pile of Mavericks. A gain of about 2 and 3 yards.
Looks like 2. 15 is also there for the Mavs. That's Ethan Hurton.
Second and six, the ball on the 36-yard line. Receiver to Huskers left and right, Haug behind him. Shotgun formation. Hand it off to Haug. The game,
again,
maybe a yard. Just don't
think the Eagles can keep doing that. Hand off to Howe. They're
trying to catch up to the Mavs. Yeah. We got Moeller. We got Jacob Ebeling.
Dan Carter. Howe going to the right side here. On most of the running plays, they're sticking to him. They do a sweep to the left or right. On the Mavericks defense, they're catching on to when Howe's going to get the ball.
Pass coming here.
Yep, I agree.
Receivers to the left and right, shotgun. Husker drops back, goes to his right a little bit. Looks for Devin Nielsen in the middle of the field. Nearly caught by Devin Nielsen. Nice play there.
Deep for Devin Nielsen. Is incomplete. Buncher.
Nice throw by Husker, though. Long and short. As the ball went off Nielsen's fingers.
Fourth and four now for Windom.
Fourth and four. Possibly another play here, but could drop back to a punt.
Yep. Eagles being down 6-0. See what happens. And Nielsen drops back. Husker throws it back to Nielsen, and Nielsen punts the ball.
Nice roll. Ball landed about the 30-yard line. Good kick there by Devin Nielsen.
Yep, had a perfect bounce from it. Puts the Mavericks
on the 11-yard line. And that's going to be about a 39 plus around 10, about a 49-yard punt.
By the Eagles defense on this drive.
Along with Devin Homer and Ethan Johnson.
And if Mavericks do decide to punt, that's going to give the Eagles quite good field positioning. Hopefully they get a scoring drive here. Swing the Mavericks punt here. From their own end zone. Kick is up. Very high punt, not going to get very much distance. Nielsen's going to let it go there.
And a ball will be down around the 44-yard line. Good field position now for the Windom Eagles.
puts the ball on about the 44-yard line.
Very good field position.
Yep. Hopefully we can get a good drive going here by the Eagles.
.734 left. Eagles start their second drive of the half. Huska and shotgun, two receivers. Nielsen goes in motion. It's going to be a handoff to Nielsen, who finds room up in the middle. Still on his feet, still going. Is taking down.
A big run by Kevin Nielsen.
At about the 34-yard line.
That's the Windom Eagles.
Very good run as they get that first down there.
Yep, nice play there. Good blocking as Devin Nielsen stays behind all the blocks. Which ends at a first down.
35-yard line, marking at the 33.
Huska's going to be in shotgun again.
First and 10. And off to Zamzow, still on his feet.
Bowler along with Jacob Appling on the tackle for Martin County West. And Ryan Zanzo picks up 6 yards, second and four.
Zamzow with a nice run there for the Eagles. Zamzow being a junior this year. He's very, very short but very quick on his feet for the Eagles. Receiver to Huskers left and right. Haken behind him.
Hand off to Haken up the middle. Pushing through some defenders. Still on his feet, pushing the pile forward. Still going. After the big pile there, looks like they got another Windom Eagles first down.
Awesome offensive play there. As,
yep.
He stays on his feet, and then you see those guys come up behind him, keep pushing him forward. That's awesome.
Yep.
You
see the big line coming in.
Brown home.
Like Pigman, Homer, Fogg.
Not a tackle. Seth Nelson, pile. Number 54, 11, Matt Moore, 37. Hogg will carry it for another. Windom Eagle, first down.
Husky's going to be under center on this play. Zamzow goes in motion. Rolls out to his right, looks for Austin Baster on the right side. He gets back in out of bounds.
He's back. By Austin Fast, he's driven out of bounds by Buncher along with Moeller. And that football's going
to be good pass there to get into the receiver's hands.
Yeah.
Eagles on the stride here so far, missing off the plays, which I think has helped out.
Yep.
Helped out as far as getting more yards each play. Definitely like the play.
Another Windom Eagle.
Husky's going to be under center. Looks like the same formation as last play.
Yep.
Possibly seeing a handoff here to Haug, though. Being so close to the end zone. Zamzow goes in motion. Handoff to Haug up the middle. He pushes his way. Gain about a yard there.
Yep.
Hooks him out about the
5-yard line.
Same play there. Because Husky gave the ball to Haug.
51 is Aaron Burmeister.
Ball in the 6-yard line. Second and six.
See if the Eagles can score here.
And what do we got here? Uh-oh. I don't like the looks of that one.
Flag thrown there. I don't know if there was something going on between a couple players down there. Whistle was blown before the snap went off, but I don't know, it's probably the second time we've seen a couple players get into it.
Yep. First time was number 88 from the Mavericks getting in Devin Homer's face.
Looks like it's going to be a call against the Mavericks there.
Yep.
Couple of penalties then assessed against Martin County West. This should have moved the ball past the distance in front of the goal line. ball very close to the 2 yard line. Second down and goal.
Second and goal for the Eagles. Husky's going to be under center. Going to be a quarterback keep. It looks like Husky dives in there. I don't know. It looks pretty cool. Yep.
Sam Husky on the carry.
And we'll see what the refs have to say. Husky with the keeper.
Looks like the ball is spotted just short
just
of the goal
line. Just inches of the goal line. So
inside
close there.
Inside the one. It'll be third down and goal.
Third and one now. 445, 440 left here in the third quarter. Anderson leads a 6-0. Husky under center. Inches from the goal line. Hands it off the power. And he pushes forward. Jonas Haug there pushes it in to get the Windom Eagles first touchdown of the game. Great play there by the foreigner. And also the rest of the Windom Eagles offense is pushing their way down the field. Back, looking for somebody, a lot of time, finds a receiver right in the middle,
wide open over the middle of the field is Rick Moore.
Wide open pass there for Mitch Miller.
Luke Jones coming off the pass to the tackle. That's Matt Moore with the reception there from her. He had around 25 yards, first down Mavericks.
Mavericks got a gain of 30 yards or so. Must have been a little miscommunication there by the Eagles defense.
Turn of the carry, he's going to be wrecked up there by Zach Steen. Along with Devin Homer. Homer and Steen teaming up for a big time tackle there.
Second and 10, ball in the Eagles 38. 2:40 left to go here in the third quarter. 7-6, Eagles lead the Mavericks. Trips to the right, one to the left. Shotgun. Screen pass there to Williamson, who doesn't look like he came up with it. Incomplete.
Yep. Ball hit the ground and then bounced up into his arms.
Pass intended for Williamson is incomplete.
The third and 10.
Brings up third down and 10.
What? Yeah?
He trips to the right again. Big play as he was wide open, but just never came up with it right off the hands. But a flag is also drawn to play.
There's a flag on the play. It's going to be a holding call.
Holding, yep, definitely.
Holding against the Mavericks.
Play big penalty there.
Yep.
Penalty never want one of those. It's going to make it third and 20 for the Mavericks.
And it's going to be third down and more than 20.
Let's see the Eagles come up here with the big stop.
Third down and 23.
2:17 left in the third quarter.
Goes to his right. Off in hands of Buttinger. Good defense there by Luke Gilbertson, who was guarding him.
Third pass intended for Buttinger.
Gilbertson being very athletic also.
Big play as they're going to stop and bring him forward. Fourth and 23. More than likely going to have to punt here.
Yeah.
With 2 minutes, 10 seconds left in this third quarter.
And I see the Eagles come up with another nice drive to score again.
Back to punt. Fast and Nielsen back to receive. Just up very high, not very far. High and short. It's going to come right back towards him.
Ekman punt is high but not far.
Probably a punt of
down by Gunster.
15 yards.
15 maybe. Very short punt. But that
yeah.
And Eagles will start.
To it. Eagles are going to start with a pretty good position in here.
Well, we're about their own 37-yard line or so here.
That would give the Eagles the ball on the 37-yard line. Two minutes left here in the third quarter. Eagles lead the Mavericks 7-6. Motion to the right, Sam rolls right. Passes up, and there's a flag on the play. It looks like it'll be passing interference. Looks like the Mavericks defender grabbed
on That is for Austin Fast. It's incomplete.
Austin Fast on the chest.
There's contact on the ball was in the air, and there is a flag on the field.
Pass was way over Fast's head, but still got all up in Austin's grill.
Yeah.
Hit him over, got him pass interference. That's going to move him.
That's what's going to hurt a team substantially, is plays like that.
That's a 15-yard penalty.
Yep.
Pass interference penalty will give the Eagles a first down. Ball was spotted at the Martin County West 47-yard line.
They'll bring up a first and 10 for the Eagles. The ball on the 47-yard line. 1:54 left here in the third quarter. No receivers. This time is on motion to the right. Hand off the Hog. That's right play. Looks like a gain of about 5 yards by Hog.
That was made by Ethan Hearn along with Matt Moeller. Hog will pick up about 5 yards. It's going to be second and 5.
Eagles having a good run here so far. Looks like they might have got the first down, but it's going to be really close.
Along with number 63.
Moves the chains, it's going to be a first down.
Ian Sin. And it is. Let's see here. First down, Eagles.
They'll bring up a winning Eagles first down with the ball on the 37-yard line. No receivers. Clock winding down to 40 seconds. Looks like it's going to be offside. Yep. Against the Mavericks. Yep. Only 5-yard penalty. See, the penalties tonight are killing them.
Yeah.
Definitely killing them. Mavericks are stacking up penalties.
Offside on the Mavericks. The Eagles are first down and 5.
Pitch to the left to Nielsen. Looks like he just came short on the first down.
Devin Nielsen with a nice run. Tackle was made by Dylan Jones. And that is another
first down for the Eagles.
For the Eagles. Nope, ball side short. It's second and 1.
I'll take that back. It'll be second and 1.
That is the end of the third quarter.
That will bring up the end of the third quarter for the winning Eagles. Eagles leading the Mavericks 7-6 at the end of the third quarter.
Red Rock Circle Drill.
And we're back. We are back. Both teams take the field. As the fourth quarter begins, 7-6, Windom leads MCW. Again, a nice drive by the Eagles, mixing the offense up with a couple different plays. And the Eagles getting a touchdown and the extra point gives them a 7-6 lead over the Martin County West Mavericks. Eagles ball on the 28-yard line. Hand off to Hog up the middle. Great tackle. Pushes his way past the first down. Very nice play. I kind of like that one.
Yep. Tackle. Let's stick in that formation here.
That
is
six or seven plays, and it's been working out.
We're going to need a first down.
That formation gives Huska a couple options, pitching the ball, handing it to Howe, and the possibility of rolling to his left or right, passing the ball.
This thing goes in motion, handoff, big handoff, I believe.
Cast awesome fast, nearly caught my awesome fast, hair too far.
Again, you'd rather be Austin Fast is in
too long than short on your passes.
Ethan Hurd on the coverage there for the Mavericks.
Austin Fast nearly came up with that.
That'll be second down and 10.
Nice play by the Eagles there. The Mavericks expecting a run to the left with the same formation they've been running. Husky keeps the ball rolled to his right with an incomplete pass to Austin Fast in the end zone. Huska in shotgun formation. Gobison to his left. Fast to his right. Motion to the left. Huska loses the ball.
The ball is loose. Fumble on the play.
Fumble on the play. We'll see who came up with the ball at the bottom of the pile.
Like Nielsen jumped on it.
But... yep.
And the Eagles have recovered the ball. Devin Nielsen, we believe, recovered it.
Like
the Eagles have an injury.
Injury on the play.
Looks like it's out, possibly. It looks like it's Jonas, yeah.
Yeah.
Which is not good. Key player for the Eagles.
Yeah, very, very big player for the Eagles. Jeff Huska taking a look at Haug.
Along with Coach Elwell and Athletic Director Dane Nielsen.
Yep.
Hopefully nothing too serious as he gets up there.
Yep.
With a little bit of help and walks. Looks like he's walking fine.
Jonas Haug, he's the player. He's coming off on his own.
Huska just got shook up a little bit there at the bottom of the pile. Both teams come back onto the field. Eagles facing a 3rd and 11 with the ball 21 yard line.
Being this close, hoping to get something good here.
Yeah. Same formation they've been running a lot. Huska to the center. Makes the pitch, looks left. Passed off. Oh, nearly came. Awesome pass, nearly came up with a pass. Just off his hands.
Huska's pass intended for Austin Fast.
Very nice play there.
Yep. Austin Fast just out of the reach of the ball. Nice pass by Huska. Good location.
4th and 11.
Brings up 4th and 11. It will be interesting to see what the Eagles do here and whether they punt or go for it.
I want to think they might go for it being this close to the end zone.
Yep. Yep.
Our team is not going to get him anywhere.
Yep.
Second timeout's going to be called by that Mavericks.
It is a timeout on the field.
Seven to go here in the fourth quarter. Windom Eagles lead the Mavericks 7-6. Ball on the 21-yard line. 4th and 11. It'll be interesting to see what the Eagles do here. Thank you. them now. .07 to go here in the fourth quarter. Eagles lead the Mavericks 7-6. Husker drops back. Throws to his right. And it looks like
pass broken up there by Ethan Hearn.
Intended for Luke Gilbertson.
Alright, we got Haas' pass in the corner of the end zone intended for Devin Wilson.
Too bad that they couldn't do something with that drive being so close to the end zone.
Yep.
Intended for Gilbertson. Luke Gilbertson.
You guys are going to have to play some really good D here. Don't want him to score again.
And yep. Martin Cody West will take over and
turn over to the Mavericks. With an attempted pass to Devin Nielsen on the right side of the end zone.
Ethan Hearn does the option play, pitches it to Dylan Jones, who doesn't.
Dylan Jones on the carry.
Gets maybe a couple yards there on that play.
Adam Berry along with Sam Hussa and Jesse Pinkman in on that tackle. Three-yard gain will bring up second down at 7.
Mavericks will be facing a 2nd and 7 with the ball on the 24-yard line.
Hearn and shotgun. Two receivers to his left and right.
Again, we need a big defensive stand here by the Eagles.
Option play there. He throws it to Dylan Jones, who breaks free in the middle of the field.
About
the 9-yard line. Devin Nielsen comes up behind him and jumps.
A touchdown saving tackle by Devin Nielsen. And as Dylan Jones came through a hole, and he rambles about 70 yards probably. That wouldn't be 70, it would be all 60.
Very nice run there as he breaks free in the middle of the field.
Yeah, remember sticking to the option play.
Seems to be working out pretty well for them tonight.
Yeah.
First and 10, Mark Tony West.
Nice hustle play there by Devin Nielsen to keep the Mavericks from scoring on that last play.
Ethan Hearn keeps it. He's going to shuffle in there for a touchdown.
Yeah.
Ethan Hearn with a nice piece of running.
Martin County West
he
with a touchdown.
Left, and he'll score from 8 yards out.
Well,
and that puts Martin
very
County
quick
West
offensive drive back to
the
Mavericks as they had that big game. Dylan Jones taking it upfield and then next play, touchdown by Ethan Hearn.
Yep.
Took about just about 2 minutes off the clock, so
yep.
Very quick.
Going to the
Hearn pass to wide open Brandon Williamson.
Brandon Williamson.
It's good for the 2-point conversion.
It was wide open on the left side of the
field.
2-point conversion for the Mavericks, putting the score
9:38 remaining in the fourth quarter. Martin County West 14 and Windom 7.
14-7, Martin County West leads the Windom Eagles. .9:38 left here in the fourth quarter. Eagles going to have to come up here with a fast drive.
Williamson going to be kicking off the Mavericks. We have Gilbertson now back in the place of Fast, and along with Devin Nielsen to receive the kick.
Yeah. nice catch on the onside kick.
Received there by Austin Garms, number 62.
Number 62
very good play. Keep it within.
Is Austin Graham. Austin Barnes. Barnes makes a nice catch of that. And Windom will have the football.
Eagles here with a good position on the field. Along the 44.
Eagles down 14-7. This is an average lead to Eagles. Keep it to the Huskers left and right, hunt behind them. Pushing them to the left. Nielsen with a nice run.
Yeah, but Nielsen will get a lot of yards on that one.
A gain of about
Matt
6 Miller yards,
will make
7
the
yards.
The Mavericks. Nielsen's gain is for 7. It's going to be 2nd down and 3.
They'll bring up 2nd down and 3 for the Eagles. Puts the ball on the 49-yard line. 9. Clock winding down to 9 minutes here in the 4th quarter.
A nice run. Puts the ball on the 19-yard line. A couple jukes there by Nielsen and a step on. Puts him onto the 19-yard line. Nice run there by Devin Nielsen.
Looked like the Eagles ran the same exact play as before. Just getting a couple more yards on this one, but I did see a flag thrown on the play.
Yep.
And it looks like it's the Mavericks as they move the ball farther. Yep. Looks like that puts the ball on the 10-yard line.
Very nice run there by Devin Nielsen as he broke free there on the left side.
Yep, Nielsen being a senior this year, being very athletic. Also in hockey and baseball.
Husker's going to line up in shotgun formation, looks like, but
receivers to his left and right.
.853 left in the 4th quarter.
Looks like the refs moved the ball up a yard, putting the ball on the 9-yard line. Receiver to Huskers left and right, hug behind him. Nielsen motions to the left.
Same play, the hand off to Devin Nielsen, but he gets met up by there at the line.
Looks like a gain of about 2 yards, maybe. Maybe 3.
On a tackle for the Mavericks, we got number 63, Sim, along with 51, Burmeister.
Puts the ball on the 5-yard line, bringing up a 2nd and 5.
Husker's going to be in shotgun again. Receivers to the left and right. Zamzar goes in motion. Hand off to Howell at the middle.
Ooh, looks like he just fell short of the end zone, but
he's gonna be
tripped up there. Looks like he came up inches short of the end zone. It'd be huge for the Eagles to get a touchdown here along with the extra point. Or 2-point conversion would give them the lead. As the score is 14, Martin County West leading the Eagles with 7.
Whistle blown there.
Whistle on the play.
Timeout Mavericks.
The Eagles take a timeout.
A couple nice runs by the Mavericks. Or I should say, one big run by the Mavericks. Puts them in good field position to score as they scored. And that gave them the lead 14-7 after they got the 2-point conversion. The Eagles come back and have a couple nice plays. Another nice play by Nielsen with a nice game. Puts the Eagles in good, really good field position to score on the 2-yard line. 7:28 here, left in the 4th quarter.
The White Sox have tied things up, 2-2 now in the bottom of the 6th.
Awesome. Both teams taking the field now.
Husker check on formation. Zamzar goes in motion. Hand off to Haug up the middle, but gets taken down.
Haug is stopped short of the goal line. Moeller and Willie among the tacklers for the Mavs.
Coming up a fourth and three to go.
Eagles really needing this right now.
Yep.
Don't want to give this one up.
Big play here.
Fourth and goal from the three.
As it is fourth down. Clock winding down to 6:40 here in the fourth quarter. Maps the Eagles 14-7. Whistle blown before the play. Looks like there's a flag.
Offside penalty against the Eagles.
Offside there was called. It's going to bring the Eagles back 5 yards.
Fourth down and goal from the 8.
Having the Eagles on the 8-yard line. Crunch time here for the Eagles.
Nielsen goes in motion, handoff. Will be quarterback keep there as Husker runs into the end zone.
Nice in the end zone.
A very nice play. Touchdown,
baby.
Good play, but there is a flag.
Here's the touchdown.
Nice play there by the Eagles. Husker fakes the ball to Devin Nielsen. Keeps it.
There is a flag on the play.
There's a flag on the play now.
Penalty against the Eagles will negate the touchdown.
Holding is going to bring back even farther now, 10 yards from where they first started. So that touchdown will not count.
Nope. Really hurting the Eagles there.
Yes. Not the time to be making these penalties, but you know, got to deal with it, I guess.
Yep. We'll see what the Eagles can do here with the ball put back on the 19-yard line. Eagles were just inches short of the end zone. And now they end up back at the 19-yard line. Trips to the right, one receiver to his left. Husker shotgun. Husker dropped back. And is sacked.
One sack. The Mavericks number 51, Aaron Burmeister.
Well, that's where that penalty is going to come in to hurt him.
Yep. Very unfortunate for the Windom Eagles.
And the Mavericks will pick over on downs.
Puck is at 6:19. As the Eagles get stopped there.
Be a turnover on downs.
It's just unfortunate.
Yep. Too bad. 6:19 left, hoping stopping the Mavericks here.
Yep, still a lot of time left in the game here.
Looking to turn it around.
Yep.
Hearn in shotgun formation. Keeps it, goes to his left. Flag down the line of scrimmage, but there is another flag. Drone.
Kevin Homer there on the tackle for the Eagles, along with Zach Steen.
Homer and Zach Steen there on the tackle.
Holding against the Mavericks.
Holding against the Mavericks. I believe, is a 10-yard penalty, which will put them on the 10-yard line. Clock running down to 6 minutes. The Mavericks lead the Eagles 14-7 on the 10-yard line. First down, 20 yards to go. Two to his left, two to his right. Option play there.
Puts it to Dylan Jones.
On a pitch, Dylan Jones on the...
In about a couple yards there.
Jesse Pittman, number 75 on the tackle. Injury on the field. Maybe Dylan Jones is gone.
Maverick injury on the field there. The clock stops at 5:32. On the 14-yard line, it'll bring us 2nd and 17 with 5:32 left in the game. Both teams setting up here. Two receivers to his left, two to the right. Drops back, looks over the middle. Nearly intercepted by Sam Huska. Just couldn't come up with it.
Broken up by Devin Nielsen.
Excuse me, Devin Nielsen.
By Sam Huska.
Well, Sam Huska was the one that nearly intercepted the ball. As he dove.
Brings up a 3rd down and 17.
Bring up a 3rd down and 17. Let's see if the Eagles stop the Mavericks here. It'd be a big stop for them. They stop them, the Mavericks punt. The Eagles will have a good field position. Hand off up the middle. He's met by a...
Turn on the carry. First hit by Flinkman. Leo Flinkman for a window making a tackle.
Another corner from Windom, Leo Flinkman, makes a tackle on that one.
Put the Mavericks in the fourth
down. They get a 4th and 17. Nice play there. Great job by the defense again.
Yep.
Stopping
nice
them.
Job. Assuming the Mavericks punt here, they will give the Eagles good field position and a good opportunity to score here as the clock winds down to 4:50 here in the fourth quarter.
Flag thrown there.
Yeah.
Not sure what it was, but it's against the Mavericks. They take them back 5 yards. Not really sure what the flag was thrown for, but
no.
Whatever it was, takes them back 5 yards.
Yeah. Haven't seen any indication of what the call was. They'll bring out 4th and 20, and I believe the Mavericks will punt here. Again, giving the Eagles a good opportunity to score here. 4:37 left.
Punt by Ekman, very high punt again, as usual. Devin's gonna fair catch at the 40-yard line.
Ekman's
that is gonna be really good field position for the Eagles to score with only 4:31.
And Haken will have the football out at the 40-yard line.
There's a flag on the play, though, so the refs are discussing what happened there, and we'll see what happens. A little chilly down here at Island Park tonight. About 50 degrees here. Full start, it looks like, against the Mavericks. They're going to decline it.
Against the Mavericks, will decline. It'll be Windom Eagle football from the Mountain County West 40-yard line.
So no change there. Going to start at the 40-yard line. Here in the fourth quarter. Martin County West Mavericks lead the Eagles 14-7. Ball 40-yard line. Receiver to Huskers left and right, Howard behind him. Huskers drops back, looks to his left and throws it short. Looks like it's intercepted by Williamson.
Room an interception by Brandon Williamson.
Huskers looks like he was hit on the pass. Reverse the call.
It's now ruled that the ball hit ground first. It's an incomplete pass.
One ref was had a good view of it. And he called incomplete pass. The ref behind the catch called it an interception. But the ref that had the better view thought otherwise.
And I'd have to agree that it did look like it bounced a little bit before he caught it.
Yep. I agree. 4:24 left, 2nd and 10.
Zamzow goes in motion. Whistle is blown and the flag is thrown. I feel like we've been having a lot of those late tonight.
Yep, too many flags. And it looks like it's against the Eagles.
Full start penalty called against the Eagles.
Full start.
Moves the ball back to the 45-yard line. And it will be. Second and 15
for the Eagles. Yep. Puts them back 5 yards.
4:24 left still here in the fourth quarter. Let's see if the Eagles can get something going. Trips to the left, receiver to the right, Husker shotgun formation. Husker drops back, looks left, throws left over the middle. Nearly caught by Devin Nielsen. Looks like there's no flag on the play.
Pass intended for Devin Nielsen is incomplete. On the coverage here, number 27. The Mavericks at Zach McNeil. We'll be third down now and 15. Go, Windom!
Third and 15 for the Eagles. Ball on the 45-yard line, 4:19 left.
Receivers to Husker left and right. Husker drops back. Looks left and right, scrambles to his left, throws the ball to the left. Ball sails.
That's
too high for
Nielsen is incomplete.
Nielsen.
Bunter on the coverage for the Mavericks.
Hold up.
Brings up a fourth down and 15.
Incomplete pass there. The intended receiver was Devin Nielsen, but it's a little too high.
I feel like there's a good chance that we'll go for this.
Yep, definitely with only not much time left, they got to do something here.
Yep, about 4 minutes down by 7. Looks like they're, yep, we're going to go for it. Husker drops back. Out of time.
In
incomplete pass there by thrown by Huska.
Huska hit as he throws.
Looks like he was hit pretty hard, though.
Incomplete.
Huska hit seconds after he threw the ball. Maybe he just hit.
The Mavericks will take over on downs. Ball at the 45-yard line.
Turnover on downs. Ball on the 45-yard line. Mavericks ball. With 4:08 left here in the fourth quarter, the Mavericks lead the Eagles 14-7.
Hearn in shotgun, two receivers to his left and right. As he runs to his left.
Hearn on a rollout run. He's taken down in by Devin Homer. Along with Sam Huska. And Hearn will gain a yard at second down and nine.
Bring up second down and nine. Clock winding down to 3:45.
Shotgun formation. Another quarterback keep. He bounces off. Finds some room to his left, and he's still on his feet, never taken down there.
Wow. Looks like two Eagles had a hold of him.
He's got a Hearn.
Kept on his truck and kept
hard
going.
To bring down. Sam Huska finishes his battle. And Hearn will get.
Very nice run there by Hearn. Doing whatever he can.
Probably about 31 yards on the run.
Keep the ball moving.
Yep.
Time coming off the clock.
3 minutes, though. You still think about it. 3 minutes. I mean, you get a stop here. I mean, you still got a chance at the whole game. But we'll see what happens. Put the ball on the 23-yard line. First and 10, goes to the right, and is taken down.
Jesse Pigman on the tackle, was not going to get much.
Colin, Clerc, part of the crew 22, as he ran the scoreboard down here at Island Park tonight for the first time.
There's a fumble.
There's a fumble on the play there.
Yeah.
Just dropped out of the hands of Ethan Hearn.
Play like that can turn the game around pretty fast here,
down.
Even though there's a minute and 45 seconds left.
And 10. No, I have third about 15.
That'll bring up third and 15 here, so it's crunch time for the Eagles.
.125 left. Clock's still running, so the Mavericks taking as much time as they want as they call a timeout.
Yep.
We are first time out of the half.
Called by the Mavericks.
1:18 left here in the fourth quarter. Not much time now, but the Mavericks coming out of the timeout we face with a third and 15 with the ball at the 28-yard line. So a fumble interception or a defensive stop here could lead to an Eagles touchdown with a couple of good plays, a couple of fast plays, I should say.
Yeah.
I'd say between the first and second half, though, we've seen a change between both offenses, running more passing plays, changing up the formations, and trying some different things, and it's worked pretty good for both the teams, but the Mavericks are still leading the Eagles 14-7 here in the fourth quarter. Both teams setting up here now.
Kroon's going to be in shotgun formation. He has two receivers to his left. He's going to run to the left there. As he is tackled down.
Ethan Hearn will roll left.
Going to bring up fourth down.
Devin Holder on a tackle for the Eagles.
Puts the Eagles at, Mavericks.
Holder will pick up probably 7 yards.
At about the 21-yard line. A minute 10 left here in the fourth quarter.
The Eagles take their final timeout.
The Eagles are going to take their final timeout of the game. 1:10 left, 7-14. The Eagles are going to have to do something here quick if they want to bring it back.
Yep, that's right.
We're going to cut to a short commercial break. Field. 1:10 left. Turned in shotgun formation. More than likely looking to something up the middle. Keeps it and goes to his right. And he's taken down.
Turned on the 30 to the right.
At the 27-yard line.
And then tackled by Devin Holder.
It wouldn't be a ball with a minute left here in the fourth quarter.
And Windom will take Holder on down. We need Eagle ball with a minute and 1 second left.
Minute left in the game. Like I said, turn one down. The interception or fumble can be huge here for the Eagles. As it turns out, the turnover on downs may keep the Eagles in this ball game if they come up with a couple of big plays here, as there is a minute and 1 second left in the fourth quarter. Receivers to left and right. Husky's going to be in shotgun formation. Drops back, rolls right. Looks for receivers, rolls over the middle.
Hustle pass intended for Zamzow is incomplete.
Intended for Zamzow, pass is incomplete. Husker hit hard there though. Slow to get up. Seconds left. Ball on the Eagles 25-yard line. Shotgun formation. Zamzow goes in motion. Husky drops back. He doesn't have any time to throw. Gets a big sack. Nothing at all. Looks like the Mavericks just came right in there and took him out.
Yep. Not much time there for Sam Husky to do anything with the football. A little bit of urgency on the field here.
Pass intended for Luke Gilbertson is incomplete. Stop.
Pass incomplete there.
Intended
for Luke Gilbertson.
Moving up on 4th and 17 with 21
and Eagles
seconds.
And the Eagles face down with a 4th down with about 17.
4th and 17. Nothing at all coming from this drive at all for the Eagles.
Nope. It's a home stretch right here.
Do or die for the Eagles tonight.
play here for the Eagles. Husker throws deep. Intercepted by Jacob Buttinger.
Yeah.
And he runs the ball out of bounds there. With 9 seconds left.
Husker's pass intended for Luke Gilbertson is intercepted by Dylan Buncher and returned from the midfield stripe all the way down to the 30-yard line.
And I assume that the Mavericks are taking knee here, let the clock run out.
Yep.
After the game here tonight, we will have commercials, and then we'll have a game recap after them.
And even her takes a knee and it'll end it.
And the clock's going to run out.
Congratulations to the Mavericks of Martin County West on their 14-7 victory here tonight at Island Park.
The clock has ran out. We're going to cut to a short commercial break.
We'll see you again next week for the Jackson County Central versus Windom Area High School football game. JCC versus Windom. Next Friday night at Island Park.
Mavericks against the Windom Eagles. The Mavericks defeat the Eagles 14-7. Starting off the first half, Windom Eagles offense was pretty slow. A lot of drives. And then I think they got the touchdown in the first half, didn't they? The Eagles?
Yep, second quarter.
Second quarter. Jonas Howard, a yard run or so, got the touchdown. And then in the second half,
not much offense.
But yeah,
there wasn't much offense for the Windom Eagles at all.
No,
they didn't score. Came close, but penalties hurt them. Brought them back. Turnover on downs, nothing good.
Yep. Couple big plays by the Mavericks led to their two touchdowns.
About a 60-yard run by Dylan Jones there in the second half.
Yeah, that really hurt the Eagles. That led to a touchdown.
Tonight's game has been brought to you by Crew 22. Crew has Matt Theesfeld, Austin Haken, Yanick Tade, Alex Woizeschke, John Irwin, Colin Clerc, Eric Hanson, Brown Ogeka, Brian Ogeka, and I think Ethan was there too.
Yep. He was just watching though.
All right, well, that's going to wrap up tonight's game. I'm Matt Theesfeld.
I'm Austin Haken.
We'll see you next week.
Thanks.